Would you let an 8-year-old manage your checking account? Would you let a 10-year-old have access to your credit card? Would you let a 12-year-old make the decision on whether or not you can buy a house? No, no, of course you wouldn't. You're probably wondering where I'm even going with this. Well, let me help you guys. I'm gonna tell you a story about something that happened to a client, and I think it will all make sense. So we had a deal where the money was very tight, so tight on the closing costs and everything else. And so we got a week before closing, we checked the bank statements, there was enough money. And I was talking to the client about the final amount, which was exactly what we had thought. And she had said, we're gonna have to delay until I get my next paycheck. And I said, what? We went over this like 322 times. I don't understand what happened. My daughter, she has access to this account and she bought some jeans. She bought a couple hundred dollars worth of clothes. And so now I don't have enough money. Okay, so that's what happened, right? Here's the thing. People are giving their children access to online ways to pay that tie to checking and credit cards. You know, you've got PayPal, you've got your Amazon account, you've got DoorDash, you've got Caviar, you've got Venmo, Instacart, you know, all these different ways. Oh, and let's not forget iPhone, right? The Apple Store, woo, that one cost me a lot a couple years ago. All these different ways to pay for things. And as parents, we always want to make stuff easy for our kids, right? So if we have a kid who's playing a lot of, you know, mommy, I want to download an app. Okay, baby, just press the button. You know, you set up that iPad so they can just buy the apps because they've always asked permission, right? Well, here's the thing. Kids do not have the financial wherewithal to know if their purchases are going to bankrupt you. No, they don't. They're kids. You know, this little girl who bought the jeans, she wouldn't have bought the jeans if she knew it was going to mean her parents couldn't buy the house, right? But how is she supposed to know that? She's a kid who has access to mom's account, who whenever she asked to buy clothes before, it was totally cool. So why would this be any different? Right? That's the thing. These kids don't have your full financial picture, and you're putting your financial kingdom in their hands anytime you give them these passwords. Yes. So, you know, my first thing would be, don't give your kids passwords to anything. Like realistically, this whole click, click, buy technology that we have now, you don't feel spending money. There's so many people who are gonna be in trouble because spending money, you really, it's just not even real anymore, right? It's like, you know, you could wake up at 12 o'clock in the morning and be like, I'm gonna become a donut maker and buy all the donut making supplies on Amazon and have them shipped within a day. Instant gratification, right? This is not a true story. Anyways, and then you've got stuff like, you know, the Apple Store where there's in-app purchases. And as a grown-up, I can look at in-app purchases and be like, yeah, nice try. Like, I'm not gonna get addicted to your Candy Crush Saga game. Like, no, right? But to a 10-year-old, they don't realize that this game was developed to ply money from their hands. They think it's a fun game. And they think if they buy, you know, 25 Snobo berries or whatever the hell it is for 50 cents or a dollar or $2, do you want more Snobo berries for $3 or 50 cents, another dollar, another, they don't get it, right? And as parents, expecting them to get it is our fault. They're not gonna get it. So the way to protect yourself and your wallet is to either A, give them zero access, right? Or B, set up another account, like a small account with like maybe $50, $100, and set up passwords tied to that account. And I would argue, in addition to that, if you set up this small account and it has $100 in it, I would give them $100 in cash as well, and I would make them give me the money every single time they click that button. Oh, you bought 5 Snobo berries? Give me $5, right? Make them feel it. Because if they don't, how will they ever know, right? You know, if you're 20, 30, 40 years old, we all went through that with our parents or, you know, or at least life where we had to pay for stuff with cash. And it's really over the last 10 years that cash has disappeared. So for all these kids who are growing up in this click, click, buy technology, you know, they've got a lot ahead of them that's gonna be very hard because spending money isn't real. But the key to all of this is that do not put your financial future in the hands of an 8-year-old, a 10-year-old, a 12-year-old, a 16-year-old. There's no way they're going to understand everything that's going on in your financial world, and they could make a mistake that could cost you dearly. So I hope this has been helpful. Thank you for watching.